construction industry is a second or third largest impacting industry in the world in sustainability. Given that, construction industry is a great place to also make a change. So Upavan is a good, exciting project because it's a little outskirts of Bangalore, but in the direction where there's going to be population boom in the next few years. So one of the first goals we set was how can we be a community which has zero water discharge, which inherently meant also that can we reduce the amount of fresh water we purchase from outside. We have decided that technology is going to help us greatly with the aid of sensors and smart meters, and now residents paying for what they consume as opposed to a generic water costing, we found that we could actually reduce the consumption further. We also wanted to make it aesthetically strong to fit into a project of the title Upavan. So we've designed ponds and bioswales. These are traditional Indian techniques which are ways to capture water and keep the rainwater within the project so that we reuse it. So with that design, we've maximized rainwater consumption. Now beyond that, we realize we need some more sources of water with the goal, remember, that zero discharge and nearly zero tanker purchase. With that as goal, we realize that we need some more water for consumption. Everything other than your toilet and kitchen where you would wash, especially meat, is black water. Everything else is grey water. And this water is now accepted, approved by everybody that it doesn't require the kind of treatment we do for traditional sewage. Water is concerned together. Now, the other aspects of sustainability which have been integrated here are waste management. It's been exciting to see how we got the affirmative approach from the designers, so that we have designed to set up a biogas plant which will take care of the wet waste and convert into renewable energy, so that again need from BESCOM for lighting common areas is reduced. So between the solar setup on the rooftop and the biogas, we are ensuring that all the common areas have no dependency on BESCOM.
So we have introduced, along with the orchard, alongside the orchard, we are introducing different diversity of tree species that are both flowering and fruiting. So the whole aspect is also about connecting the community to this this diversity. Many of the flowering species are also medicinal, and there are certain tree species like custard apple and rose apple that we want the children to connect with, you know, and bring an aspect of this nature to their childhood. This apart, we are also introducing a lot of medicinal herbs, which will be part of the bioswale and other areas that we are recreating on the sustainability side. And the medicinal herbs that we are talking about, it could just be leaves plucked and used for common ailments like cold and cough. And that's also one aspect that we would like to reintroduce back to the communities, where the communities are also connecting back to the tradition.